Hello, I'm Dani. Welcome to the workshop. In today's video, I will show you some tricks for assembly mates, one of which I found out just a few weeks ago while I was working with imported PCBs. It doesn't matter that I found it while I was working with imported PCBs. It's very comfortable in many different situations. Stay with me to see what I'm talking about. For many of you, when you receive a step file of PCB, it's looking like this, but it's not enough for the work you have to do with this. And you have to put the real components on this board so you can do your job well. One place where you can find a lot of components is a 3D content central. You have just to look for what you need. And it will give you a choice of files for download. But let's go back to our board. It's looking like this. Sometimes even the sizes are wrong. So what I was doing in the past, these are my replaced components. Let's take this one, for example. I was just starting to mate it with the component which I already have on the board. And once I was ready, I was just fixing it and deleting the original component. But what came to my mind just recently is you start to edit the board, add a new sketch, and then convert all the boxes that you have. Now, once we are done with this, we just right click, display delete relations, and delete all. This we will need because once we are ready with this part, we will delete the parts which are actually making these contours. The next step is to go to features, curves, and split line. And you make a projection of this on the board itself. Once we are ready, we can return to our main assembly and just delete the components that we don't need anymore. When we are ready with this, you will see you have these faces representing each of the components. And from this point, the mating is really easy. You just need a profile, rectangular profile on your component and such on the board itself. And use profile center. As long as you have some rectangle, you can use this kind of mating. If you need to switch the position, you can rotate it. And also you can add some distance. Well, for these components, it's really easy. It's a bit harder for the USBs that we have on both ends, but it's also possible. All you have to do is first measure what's your board thickness. It's 0.6. Then start editing this space here, edit part, new sketch, make a rectangle. This to be collinear with this, which will be laying on your board. And then we have 0.6 as the thickness of the board. And we use again split line. Now we have a profile here, which is matching the board edge. And again, we use center profile. In this case, the orientation is wrong. So we have to rotate it. And also the position is wrong. We need some distance in the opposite direction. Now we have to do the same thing with this here. If you don't want to guess the distance, you can also measure it. And it's 0.7. And this is how fast and easy you can position your components.
Thank you for watching. In the next week, I will publish a video in which I will show you what is it to be in person on 3D Experience World, which was one great and amazing event. Also, I expect to receive some of my favorite devices, which I use with SolidWorks, and I will make a video which is suitable in what situations. So stay tuned. And don't forget to subscribe and like the video. See you next time. Bye.